Hello guys, it's Shade Gray coming at you with a little bit more of Time Splitters Arcade Mode. Now as of right now, I have every Time Splitters Arcade Mode recorded. I have all of Metal Arms and Glitch in the System's chip guide, although I kind of skimped out in the last couple of levels and there was one I couldn't find in another one. But anyway, that's not why you're here. Today you're here for Time Splitters. And we are going into the Honorable Arcade, and we're going for...
I'm ready for anything.
And don't worry, as I have mentioned before, I will be going through and making a complete video of every character I unlock after I have done the, challenge mode. Yes,
three,
that's it.
3, 2, 1, go!
Alright. This is Zones, and this one's actually a little difficult if you don't know what you're doing. There's an easy way to cheat this level if you can figure it out. But essentially, this is a team-on-team match, as all Zone matches are, and you are all by yourself. And I got completely turned around somehow. This footage looks... No, it's not sped up. I guess you just this naturally fast. Anyway, you're versus these guys, if you remember these from the, first of the Time Splitters 2, the first Time Splitters game. I lack the ability to actually play the first Time Splitters game. These are the locations of the five zones. There's one in your base, one just barely outside your base, and... one outside their base, and one inside their base. It's just kind of one of those annoying levels where you gotta either continuously move or find a choke point. There's actually a pretty good choke point beyond that fourth zone, and I'll be demonstrating that a little bit later. But first, y'all get to watch me fail. Anyway, in this level, there are two power-ups, I believe. There are the maximum damage power-ups and the oh my god, I'm running like Speedy Gonzales speed power-ups. And I don't know why I didn't pick up a machine gun at this point, but whatever. I'm a pretty good shot with this weird pistol. Now, this is a good way to get either silver or bronze. This is not the way you get gold. Again, I will be demonstrating that in a little bit, but I'm probably going to end up killing myself or not getting the points. I really can't remember. I don't get the points. Trying to remember. Anyway, yeah, as you can clearly see, this level is a little easy, and heck, you could probably choke point this if you really, really wanted to. Just choke point them in their own base before they spawn. That would just get really chaotic really fast, though, and you might end up losing two zones. Personally, I would suggest, you'll see what I'll suggest in a moment. And I think one of those bastards got ahead of me or something, because... they got a lot more zones than they should. Okay, where are you? Second! God damn it. 36 points in 3 minutes? What, really? It's a bit of a stretch, isn't it?
3, 2, 1, go!
Anyway, this is how you should do this level. This is the easiest way to do it, and this would be the way I would suggest. And apparently you move a lot faster than they do, or they just kind of ignore one zone. But regardless, time to create a choke point. Alright, when you hit this third one, they will all be pouring out trying to get to that as well. You want to just take them all out as quickly as possible. And you can butt them in the head, you can pretty much do whatever you want. But here is where things are going to get complicated.
Open head surgery.
What you want to do is you want to create a choke point here and leave little room for error. Personally, I like the spot in this hallway right in front of the door, because the second that that thing opens, you know to start opening fire.
Killing frenzy.
And yeah, they'll get a couple of points, but it won't be anything too substantial. They only have one zone after all. You're getting, what, 4 points for every one they get? This is actually a pretty sweet deal. Now, as you can see, I've kind of created a long choke point here that I can use. This is actually not a bad idea if this door remains open, because then you can just kind of shoot them as their heads appear right under that thing. Though, if I remember right, these guys don't have as much health as, well, they're actually one of the more weaker enemies you're gonna be running into. Anyway, since I've pretty much been demonstrating what you need to do, I think this is a good time to say it. I have figured out what I'm going to do for my 100 sub special. It is going to be a live stream at some point on Ustream. And it is going to be of a very popular horror game at the moment, with a long, tall man in it. Oh, and I'm also going to be trying to be recording, I'm going to be trying to do a stream every night from now on, in between the hours of 11 Eastern and 4 a.m. Well, 11 p.m. Eastern, 4 a.m. Eastern. So if you want to swing by and watch some Minecraft or Blood Bowl or whatever, come on down and watch me. Anyway, we got the Platinum Award, which means we actually got 2 unlockables from them. I believe the Platinum unlockables are the same as the Gold unlockables, though I could be wrong about that, so you really don't have to worry. Anyway, this is another Shrinker Zone one I didn't actually get to see.
Great choice!
Yes, and we're playing as a... Oh, wait, no, this is an elimination. That's right. At least I think it's elimination. Might be shrink. Anyway, this one's kind of interesting because you have to use some unorthodox weapons. Yes, you have to use mines and motion detector mines. This gets really annoying really fast, because these things stick around after somebody dies. There we go, right. So, what you want to do is you want to aim for the feet of the person you want to kill, and you really, really want to look for either the flare gun or this gun that I'm walking up on. You can also make a direct shot with these things, but that's not the most reliable thing to do. And I think I walked into my own mine. But yes, there are 2 actual guns in this level. The flare guns, which actually have a decent amount of ammo compared to your mines, and a whole hell of a lot better range. There's also double flare guns, and along with the flare guns, we also have the heat-seeking rocket, but I don't get that for a while, I believe. Anyway, you do want to pick up as many armor and health upgrades as possible, because if you do not, you will be sorry. Oh, I think I blew you to the moon, my friend. Alright, moving on. Here we go. Heat-seeking rocket! Wow, that would have been bad if I would have fired a rocket right there, losing the heat-seeking power, and just, in general, being a complete moron. Ah, what? Lame. You know, I could let them kill each other, but I'd rather have to kill someone. I missed. Alright, whatever. Got him killed. Moving on. So yeah, you kind of get the basic idea. You want to find the flare guns or the homing rocket, just because that makes your life a whole hell of a lot easier. And the computers will try and find these items as well, so you want to get them for yourself as quickly as possible. So back to what I was saying. Yes. I do actually have a streaming channel. I have hosted about 2 streams on it. I know not a whole lot of streams, but I find that my videos get more views than my streams anyway. But yes, I will be trying to do a stream in between 11 Eastern and 11 PM Eastern and 4 AM Eastern. So, come try and join me there. And, yeah. A lot of fun. A lot of fun. I have a lot of fun throwing them. Another announcement that I could make right now, because there's not a whole lot going on. I got, 2 more people to kill? 1 more person to kill? I think I'll save that for when football season's coming around, because I do have a special I have planned for football, just pretty much because my dad is a huge football fan. Anyway, we got first place with the strategy I mentioned, and that means we have a few new unlockables. Awesome, right? Did I get frozen again? No, there we go. I don't know what platinum is for this one, but if you can do it just slightly faster than I did, just 20 seconds, then you can easily get gold. Alright, what did we unlock? We got a new character. Lion guy that we got. Awesome. Alright, now we're going to Team Deathmatch. Now, I remember this one. This is Hans. Not Hans. Ah.
Hey, wanna be in my gang?
No, Hans, I don't wanna be in your gang. But yes! This is our character we will be playing as, ladies and gentlemen, Hans. He is the biggest headshot hitbox in the entire game, and it's really fun to play with a team of idiots on big head mode with this guy. Why? Because it's pretty much target practice. Alright. This is a team deathmatch in between 3 teams. Well, should I say 2 teams and you. Construction workers and clowns. You really need to pick up the shotgun or the equivalent of this, because your machine guns are not going to be cutting it. You will die a lot in this, but lives matter not. Kills matter, so kill as many as you can, and since everybody's gunning for you, that shouldn't be that hard. The clowns actually have some pretty funny things. The construction workers, if I remember right, are actually cool. But, what you really want to do is you just want to aim for the head. Why? Because you want to take these guys down as quickly as possible. Shotguns are also very useful. If you can find a shotgun, pick it up, and just start murder brawling people. Ah, yes. Murder Brawl. Almost as much fun as Blood Bowl. Ow! So close. Wait a minute. Is that who I thought it was? No. He's not this level. He wouldn't be at this level. There are also some grenades, but I find them very useless, so... I wouldn't bother picking them up. Ow! Not even fair. Streak of 3 kills and I get my ass handed to me by a tiny fucking clown. You do wanna kind of use a basic cover system and oh my god, it's him! Mr. Giggles. I love clowns, man, but Mr. Giggles freaks me the hell out. And the grenades, they do nothing. Alright. Oh, god damn, Mr. Giggles. So yeah, that's pretty much my basic strategy for this. You really just want to rack up as high a kill count as you can, and that's not too hard since it's 6-on-1. Your kill count should be above average. Your kill count should be huge. By the end of this, you should easily have more kills than both the teams combined. Sorry, still not feeling well, but at least, I'm not sniveling the entire time. And with that strategy, we get silver. What exactly was gold? I'm curious. 36 kills in 3 minutes? Aw, oh, that's not fair. Well, regardless. Alright! Those are all of the, those are all the arcade challenges that we will be going through today. Stay tuned for more. Look for my live stream at shadegrayseyes@ustream.com. Link is in the channel. My YouTube channel, that is. Anyway. I am Shade Gray, and tell me what you think of my Ustream idea. Stay tuned for more, and I will be seeing you next time. Signing out.